Welcome, makers. Today we're going to dive into FreeCAD and create a 3D printed keyring. If you aren't running FreeCAD already, you can download it directly from freecad.org. The main workbenches we will be using are part and draft. You can think of the draft workbench as your drawing board, where you create 2D shapes, and the part workbench as your sculpting tools, where you turn those shapes into 3D objects. We will start in the draft workbench. Here we can create some simple text for the base. FreeCAD has a tool for this called the Shape from Text tool. The tool needs us to set a position for the text. We can just click anywhere on the canvas to set the position. The text is set in this string field. Any font loaded onto the system can be used. I will choose Arial Black. By default, FreeCAD may not be pointed to the fonts folder for your system. For Windows, this will be C:Windows Fonts. On a Mac, this will be /System Library Fonts or /Library Fonts. Once we are happy with the settings, we click OK to set the text. This creates a 2D shape of the text. Now we need to switch to the part workbench to extrude the shape into a 3D model. We need to be able to work on each letter separately. Currently, all of our letters are combined into a single object, but we can split these up. All that is needed is to choose part, compound, explode compound. This creates a new group in the model tab with each of our letters exploded into separate objects. Now I will select all of the odd letters and perform an extrusion. Click extrusion. This brings up a dialog box with configuration options for the extrusion. I will select 4 millimeters for the odd letters. We need to extrude the even letters too. Clicking the extrusion button again. This time, I will set the extrusion to 6 millimeters for variety. Next, we will nudge the letters together so they overlap. Orienting the viewport for a top-down view will help here. To begin, I will select all but the first letter and nudge those over. We can modify the X position by navigating to Base, Placement, Position, here in the Model tab. Now I will deselect the second letter and repeat this process until all of the letters overlap each other. I will also go ahead and shift the Y position slightly for variety and to make things more interesting. The mouse wheel can zoom in and out on the model for a better view. Holding down Shift and right, clicking the mouse lets us manually rotate the model for a better perspective. To finish off the model, we need to add a keychain loop. This is simple to do in FreeCAD. First, we add a cylinder from the part workbench. I will set this with a 2 millimeter radius and a height of 4 millimeters to match the first letter. Another cylinder can be added, which we can use to cut a hole in the first cylinder. I will give this one a 1 millimeter radius and also a height of 4 millimeters. Now I will need to select both cylinders, making sure to select the biggest cylinder first. Here I can choose part, boolean, cut, and now we have the keyring loop. We just need to move it onto the first letter. This needs to be as close to the model as possible so it won't snap off. Right-click on the keyring loop in the Model tab and choose Transform. Then slide the green and red X/Y handles to manually move the loop into position. The translation increment option can be tuned for finer movement. In this case, I feel 0.2 millimeters works well. Once you're happy with your design, you can export the model to STL format for 3D printing. With all of the objects selected in the model view, choose File, Export, STL. Next, you'll need slicing software like Cura. Cura can be downloaded for free from ultimaker.com/software/ultimaker-cura. This software takes your STL file and slices it into layers, creating instructions for your 3D printer. Don't get bogged down with all the settings at first. Here's what I recommend for PLA. Layer height, 0.2 millimeters, good balance of speed and detail. Infill, 20%, strong enough but not wasteful. Supports are not needed for this design, but are important if the design has overhanging features or long bridges. It is important to enable brim on small prints, or the object can wobble loose mid-print. Always use a brim for tiny objects. Depending on the complexity, size, and infill structure of the design, your keychain can take from 10 minutes to over an hour to print. You might need to use a spatula or scraper to remove the print. You can sand or polish your keychain for a smoother finish. Every successful print is built on a few failed ones, so don't be discouraged if things don't go perfectly at first. Keep making, keep learning, and having fun. If you have any problems, please drop a comment below and I'll help you out. Happy printing!